Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Singer-Songwriter Show number 95. And special welcome to my guest and my guest host tonight, Cindy Murphy. Gonna be a great show tonight. We're gonna feature our good friend Snuffy Smith, who unfortunately we lost almost 4 years ago now. And the first song is one that he wrote. Kind of shows a bit of his tender side, let's say.
Softer side, for sure.
Softer side, yeah. This is called The Little Things, so. Written by Snuffy Smith. Snuffy was born down down in southwestern Virginia in 1963. The town was called Appalachia, Virginia. I looked it up, and it's if you drive in, it's about 50 miles from there to Mesa Spring, where the Carter family were from, down near the Tennessee border. Appalachia is up near the Virginia border with Kentucky. We lost Snuffy back March 15th, 2017, so coming up on 4 years. His real name was James Theodore
Snuffy Smith.
Snuffy was a childhood nickname. He didn't like his given name, and he legally changed it to Snuffy, so good for him. So, anything else you want to say?
No, he loved to entertain and really taught me my own voice. So, I mean, I was playing a lot of instruments, but didn't really trust my voice until he came along and helped me find the courage to use it.
Yeah. Since I mentioned the Carter family, Cindy was telling me that Snuffy always said he did have some distant relation somehow connected to the Carter family back down there in Virginia. So that's kind of cool when you think about all this music. The very first show I did, number one of this 100 singer-songwriters, was the Carter family. So, all right. This next song Snuffy didn't write, but he sure loved to do it, and we got to have him sit in with us over at Chief's Tavern on Cottage Grove Road many times with Hoot Nanny on our every other Thursday night show. And this one is a song that Waylon Jennings and Willie Nelson made famous. Cindy was telling me that this album from Willie Nelson, The Redheaded Stranger, was a big favorite of Snuffy's. So this song was written actually by Chips Moman and Bobby Emmons, and they wrote it especially, of course, for Waylon and Willie, because they get mentioned in the song. And it's kind of cool because Waylon Jennings recorded it, but Willie did the harmony and then ends up singing the last verse. So I'm sure you know this one, and this is a special shout out for me to my friend Rebecca down in Austin, because she just celebrated her 60th birthday by going to Luckenbach and playing some music. So,
oh, awesome.
Just like Waylon and Willie and the boys.
Val tells me Luckenbach is tiny.
Yeah, it's just a tiny
little town.
That's a little crossroads. Yeah, so yeah. All right, so we're gonna start this one out with a little gender bending. So Cindy's gonna start it. So
there's only two things in life that make it worth living. It's guitars tuned and firm feeling women.
I don't need my name in the marquee lights. I got my song and I got you with me tonight. Maybe it's time we get back to the basics of love. Let's go to Luckenbach, Texas with Waylon and Willie and the boys. This successful life we're living's got us feuding like the Hatfields and McCoys. Between Hank Williams' train songs and Newberry's train songs and Blue Eyes crying in the rain, out in Luckenbach, Texas, ain't nobody feeling no pain.
So
baby, let's sell your diamond ring, buy some boots and faded jeans and go away. Go away. This coat and tie is choking me. In your high society, you cry all day. Cry all day. We've been so busy keeping up with the Joneses. Four car garage, we're still building on. Maybe it's time. finally got back to the basics of love. Let's go to Luckenbach, Texas, Waylon and Willie and the boys. This successful life we're living's got us feeling like the Hatfields and McCoys. Between Hank Williams' pain songs and Newberry's train songs and Blue Eyes crying in the rain. Like Texas, ain't nobody feeling no pain. Let's go to Luckenbach, Texas, Willie and Waylon and the boys. This successful life we're living's got us feeling like the Hatfields and McCoys. Between Hank Williams' pain songs and Jerry Jeff's train songs and Blue Eyes crying in the rain. And Luckenbach, Texas, ain't nobody feeling no pain. Out in Luckenbach, Texas, ain't nobody feeling no pain. Nice work, Cindy. All right, Luckenbach, Texas. That's a place to go when you need to just like let loose and play some good music and escape from daily living. So just like they're saying. So
when you get tired of your high society.
Yeah, exactly. And I just want to give a little shout out on that song to in the last verse, Willie changes it to Jerry Jeff, and we just lost Jerry Jeff Walker. I think probably about the last couple, 2-3 months. So. You know, he did most famous for writing Mr. Bojangles, but, All right, so one more song from Snuffy. It's going to be called, one he wrote, kind of a funny song, called Certain Circumstances. But before I do that, Cindy shared me with me a couple of his CDs. So here's one he did. You can see... I'm a little far away from the camera, but there's a nice shot of him there. And another one here. This one's called I Know What You Like. All right. And just want to mention that, Snuffy was a successful musician in his time. He had a song that he wrote called If You Can Only Believe back in 2000. That made it to number one on the Christian country music charts. So, had a few others that that got up there and got some airplay. So, kind of cool. All right, this last one, I think I'm going to dedicate this to the movement to decriminalize marijuana and to hopefully, give people the medicine that they need and make the people that are in prison for non-violent offenses, especially the many, many people of color that are behind bars. I just think gonna dedicate this song to to that movement and hope we're gonna have some traction with a new president. So
he would approve.
Yeah. All right, so anything you want to say about this song? It's just kind of a funny one that he did.
Yeah, so in true Snuffy fashion, I think the words changed nearly every time he did it. just a little bit, but the meaning always held. He certainly loved to partake of marijuana and other substances. And to a certain extent, it helped him fight the demons he fought. So... it was medicine for him. So.
All right, so this is one that Snuffy wrote, Certain Circumstances, and also called Getting Stoned. So. Thank you. Well, I read back in the old book so many years ago that the Lord laid down his law
so all
the people would know just how they should live their lives and what was right or wrong. And there were certain circumstances that required it stone.
Now I am
a believer. Proud to say that there's parts of that old book
that we don't
practice today.
Even though we often disagree,
I wish we all could get along. Regarding certain circumstances require getting stoned. Like the sunrise every morning, end of every day,
with
every conversation where there's nothing left to say.
When you're
happy, sad, or angry, or you just
wanna get it on.
There's certain circumstances that require getting stoned. That it's legal, most still against the law. That's wrong.
Some say that it's medicinal,
but for me it's just because.
Grows
wild all over the world,
but I prefer my own
homegrown. Those certain circumstances that require getting stoned.
Like the sunrise every morning and the
end of every day,
with every
conversation where there's nothing left to say.
When you're
happy, sad, or angry, or just get it on. There are certain circumstances that require getting stoned.
Like
the sunrise every morning at the end of every day,
with
every conversation there's nothing left to say.
Where you're
happy, sad, or angry,
just
wanna get it on. There's
certain
circumstances require getting stoned. Circumstances that require
stone.
There are certain circumstances that require stone. Song. He really loved to do that. He would just crack himself up singing that song, actually. Yeah, we had a lot of fun when Snuffy would show up at Chief's. So. All right, well, it's been an honor and a privilege to do this tribute to the late Snuffy Smith. And, you know, it was great while it lasted that we got to got to play some songs for him, so.
Under the shield.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we're being safe here at Cindy's house, so. All right, so big thanks to Cindy for hosting me and joining me on this show. It was extra special to do this together. Show number 95. So I just have five more shows before I'm going to finish this series. So the next one is going to be my good friend Tom Castle. who I first met back at the in the Capitol in 2011, the Solidarity Sing-Along. So, be coming up, I think, probably Monday night, but I'll let everybody know on Facebook. So, three songs I'll be doing of Tom's. First one is his song that he wrote to the tune of Union Maid, called The Onion. I'm sticking to The Onion for all my news. And, of course, The Onion was founded here in Madison. The next one is a sea shanty, actually. And sea shanties are apparently very popular right now.
Very popular.
Yeah. So I thought this was one that Tom wrote, but he said no. He got this from some folks up in the Maritime provinces up around, I think, Labrador in Canada. And it's called Starlight Tonight. And then I'm going to finish with a great song that Tom wrote for the Solidarity Sing-Along, all about democracy and our right to protest at the Capitol, and it's called Whose House.
Great song.
So, yeah. So thank you very much for listening. I hope you're all doing well. Happy New Year, since my last show was on New Year's Eve, and see you soon.
Stay safe.
Yay!